It certainly wouldn't be a surprise for IGN to have a take on video games that gets absolutely destroyed, that gets wrecked. It's happened time after time after time over the last decade. But you'd think that if they got this awesome game featuring a strong female character, that that would be enough to satisfy them. That would be enough to satisfy woke games journalists. Hey, look at this game where I can play as a strong woman. That would be great, right? Apparently, it's not great because this woman happens to be attractive. This woman happens to be hot and sexy and not look like a 400-pound land whale with purple hair. So when it comes to Stellar Blade, IGN is getting hammered a little bit. This is a game that has been talked about for a while now, in large part because of how the protagonist looks and the jiggle physics that are involved. I'll give you a little bit of an example here. You can see you've got your protagonist here for Stellar Blade. They definitely went all in on the jiggle physics. They wanted someone who looked hot. They wanted somebody who looked good, and they wanted to make the physics realistic. So here we are, Stellar Blade, jiggle physics on point. That was not enough for one IGN reporter, and they are now getting fucking destroyed over this. So IGN calls Stellar Blade protagonist a sexualized doll and says the creator has never seen a living woman. It's right here, and this is from IGN France, by the way. It's not new, and other games have chosen to highlight the strengths of their female characters, but where a Bayonetta stands out with an iconic character design, or 2B from Nier Automata inspires an entire generation of cosplayers, Eve from Stellar Blade is just bland. A doll sexualized by someone who has never seen a woman. And we hear that shit all the time from some of these games journalists towards their, you know, the audience, the customers, actual gamers trying to insult them like that. There's a little bit of a problem, though, when it comes to this statement from IGN. And it's the fact that not only has the creator have a beautiful, gorgeous wife who happens to be working as an artist on this game as well, but also the character Eve, the protagonist, it's based off a real fucking person. Right here, or they are getting scanned for the game. It's based off a real life model. Right here, Stellar Blade's protagonist body is based on this real world Korean model. We wanted the most attractive looking body for the user. So here you go. This is the character they were scanned in. It's all based off her body. So the idea that you think women don't look like this in the real world might say more about you than it does about the person that designed the game. And when it comes to the fans surrounding this, they have come out in droves to bash IGN and defend this game. Fans defend Stellar Blade director Hyung Tae Kim after a controversy around Eve's model that is based on Korean model Shin Jae-yoon. I don't know if I'm saying all those names right, just for the record. But the idea that this dude not only doesn't think this is a realistic body when it's literally based off somebody, this is the beautiful wife of the creator, the creator's wife and team artist. So IGN is getting fucking hammered over all this. Look at Mark's tweet. Almost 60,000 likes on this. And from pretty much every corner of the internet that's not full of insane fucking lunatics or people that think just like woke games journalists, they're bashing IGN, and rightly so. And IGN France did make a little change to this article. Not in the wording, but it says this article has been edited following death threats. Like, Jesus fucking Christ, you pussies. It is, again, no one should send death threats on the internet. I imagine it was one fucking anonymous person that sent some nasty message to him, and now they're virtue signaling over this entire thing. IGN, no stranger to getting blown out of the water by actual gamers because of their terrible takes, but this one is a whole new level of pathetic, because for somebody basically to say, oh, this dude's a virgin, they never seen a woman, not only to be married to a gorgeous woman in real life who's also an artist, but also the fact that the person they're criticizing is literally based off a real life model whose popularity probably is set to absolutely blow up because of this entire thing. That's a different story, but Stellar Blade certainly causing meltdowns in the mainstream media, and IGN just got absolutely destroyed for it.